Yeah, so good morning, good day. My name is Vladimir Mamaev, and I'm working for the United Nations Development Program for the Global Environmental Facility, actually part of it. And I'm responsible for the International Waters Portfolio in Europe and Arab states, as well as West Africa. So it's quite a big portfolio. I started to work for the Global Environmental Facility International Waters Projects back in 1993, where the first large marine ecosystem project on the Black Sea was approved by the GEF for financing and involved six countries. So I will be talking a little bit about this, because this is when we first developed the so-called TDA-SAP methodology. So I would try to demystify this abbreviation, TDA-SAP, and try to give you some background and information about what exactly we are doing. So first we will start with the TDA, which is actually transboundary diagnostic analysis. So there is three important key messages here. First of all, it's an analysis. So we are analyzing the state of the ecosystem through a specific methodology that we developed over the course of the past 20 some years for GEF projects. The important is the diagnosis, of course, because we are trying to diagnose the state of the marine ecosystem in this case, but the methodology is actually covering several types of ecosystems, the water ecosystems that we are working with. Of course, the large marine ecosystems, and we have the largest portfolio of project in marine large marine ecosystems. But we also work with transboundary rivers, transboundary lakes, transboundary aquifers. And so the important word here is transboundary. We are working only, GEF is working only in the water ecosystems where there are more than one country. So it's not national, but it's transboundary or international. So what we do there? First of all, we analyze the problems that a specific ecosystem is facing through a so-called causal chain analysis that will demystify the root causes of each problem. So back in 1994, we didn't have the methodology on how to do this, so it was very interesting how we approached this issue. So we created at this time several working groups, we call them this way, on biodiversity, pollution, fisheries issues, coastal zone management, and a couple of others, where we invited the scientists, eminent scientists from all the Black Sea countries to join us and try to understand what are the problems that the Black Sea ecosystem is facing. So through the work of these groups and then a joint group on the development of the transboundary diagnostic analysis, we're able to identify major transboundary issues. I am repeating again transboundary because we are not very much interested in the national problems, though of course we are analyzing as well, but we are identifying the transboundary problems that are common to several countries, and that these problems have to be addressed by a number of countries. So when we finalized the report, and this is a very big assessment, in the Black Sea we had, I think it was close to 250 pages report with a lot of data, because we are basing the transboundary diagnostic analysis on the existing data and information that the country's scientists have in their databases. We are not doing new studies. TDA is not about new studies, it's not about monitoring, it's not about going in the sea and measure specific things. This is the analysis of existing information. So when we finished this report, it was clear to us that there is a need now to address the issues. So this is the second part of our methodology on the TDA-SAP. Strategic action program. So the important keywords here is action and strategic actions. So we in the Black Sea, after we finalized the development of the transboundary diagnostic analysis, and I have to say that the transboundary diagnostic analysis is a document that is not negotiated by the governments is the basically a state of the environment report published on the existing data. So we do not have any politicians involved in the TDA process. We have only scientists involved. But the SAP strategic action program process of development of the SAP is important that to bring politicians, to bring economists, to bring sociologists, to bring lawyers, because this document is the negotiable document and is actually the strategy for the countries for 5, 10, sometimes 20 years on how to address the issues that have been identified in the transboundary diagnostic analysis. So this is the action document, and this is negotiated by the governments and agreed during in the Black Sea. We had 4 years, I think, we spent on the negotiation of this document. But this is a very important thing, because the country must agree to act, and they have to agree also on the financing of this action, because the Global Environmental Facility is providing only catalytical funds, and the most important baseline funds and co-financing should be provided by the governments. So the SAP process was involving a wide range of national politicians, lawyers, and other experts that have created a set of activities. I think in the Black Sea we have, we had at that time in 1997, we had close to 40 actions. Of course, all these actions implementation needs a lot of funds, and the countries decided to set priorities. So for the first 5 years, then next 10 years, and then 20 years. Also, the countries have agreed that every 5 years they would like to revisit and look at the status of implementation of this Black Sea Strategic Action Program, and to make changes, and maybe the priorities will be changed. So, as I said, the Strategic Action Program for the Black Sea was signed in back in 1996 by all the six countries, and that's was the baseline for the next GF intervention in the Black Sea, called the SAP, or Strategic Action Program Implementation Project. Of course, the implementation of the Strategic Action Program on the regional level is very important, but the most important thing is to implement this at the national level, because only with changes on the national level you will be able to achieve some results on the regional level. So as a follow-up of the development of the Strategic Action Program, the countries of the Black Sea have developed the so-called NAPs, National Action Plans. This is basically the translation of regional actions to the national ground, and the implementation is done at the national level. So since 1996, the countries have been implementing with joint efforts the Strategic Action Program, the National Action Plans, and they have revisited already twice the strategies and adjusted the strategy to the present situation.